Good afternoon and sorry for the delay. My name is Dr. Muhammad Khalil. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Hisham Al-Ghazali and his board for giving me this opportunity to stand here in front of you to discuss the results of our study comparing the role of fulvestrant versus everolimus plus exemestane in the treatment of metastatic hormone-positive postmenopausal breast cancer. So, to start, we all know that the treatment of metastatic hormone-positive breast cancer in postmenopausal female patients is mainly limited to tamoxifen and non-steroidal aromatase inhibitors, either letrozole or anastrozole. Many studies have been done to show which is better, tamoxifen or non-steroidal aromatase inhibitors in the postmenopausal setting. But what about the failure of both types of treatment? What is the next step? This is the main challenge. Third-line anti-hormonal treatment is limited mainly between fulvestrant and exemestane. Of course, we have other choices, such as megesterol acetate or estradiol, but remains fulvestrant and exemestane are the two main convenient types of treatment. However, the addition of the mTOR inhibitor, everolimus, to the steroidal aromatase inhibitor, exemestane, improves outcome when compared to exemestane alone, as shown by the Voliro 2 study, but we have no direct comparative study versus fulvestrant in this type. So, what is the aim of our study, or why are we doing this? The aim is to compare the use of fulvestrant versus the combination of everolimus and exemestane in the metastatic postmenopausal breast cancer female patients with hormone receptor positive and HER2 negative, or what you call the luminal subtype, after the failure of tamoxifen and non-steroidal aromatase inhibitors. The primary endpoint was progression-free survival, and the secondary endpoint was toxicity profile. Our inclusion criteria, very simple. Of course, metastatic breast cancer in a postmenopausal female patient, hormone receptor positive, mainly ER and HER2 negative. All our patients have received chemotherapy, tamoxifen, and non-steroidal aromatase inhibitors, either in the adjuvant or the metastatic setting. The methodology, we have collected data from 28 patients treated between September 2014 and February 2015. We divided the patients into two main groups. Group A, 16 patients received fulvestrant, the high dose, the approved dose now, 500 milligram loading every 2 weeks for 1 month and then once monthly thereafter. This is for group A. For group B, we included 12 patients who received a combination of everolimus 10 milligram once daily plus exemestane 25 milligram once daily. We collected full clinical, laboratory, and radiological data from our patients for assessment and follow-up, and of course our follow-up continued until disease progression. Our results, this is our patient characteristics. The median age was 54 years old, right breast cancer was a little bit more, and the most important point was that solitary bone metastasis or bone metastasis only was seen among 50% of our patients, which matches the luminal subtype. Regarding the side effects, in group A, the fulvestrant group, about one-third of patients suffered from hot flushes, whereas in group B, a little bit more, two-thirds of the patients have suffered from grade 2 or grade 1 pneumonitis, but this was very easily controlled by low doses of corticosteroid. Regarding the median progression-free survival, with group A was 4.5 months compared to 6 months in group B. Here we can see the minimum duration of progression-free survival with group A was 2 months only, compared to 4 months with group B. However, we have seen at least one patient who have reached 13 months of progression-free survival with group A, compared to 8 months with group B. So, to summarize, everolimus plus exemestane improved the progression-free survival, however, with slightly higher toxicity profile when compared to fulvestrant. Yet we still need more research, more studies to maybe reach a convenient type of treatment for as a third-line treatment in the postmenopausal metastatic setting. Finally, I would like to thank Professor Dr. Tamer Nahas and my dear colleague Dr. Yasmin Ashour for their endless support and their help. And thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Mohammed. Any question? Thank you.